Hey, John Sanmez from simpleprogrammer.com. So I got a question about focus, on what to focus on here from Darren. And I'm gonna read you the question here. Darren says, "Hi John, longtime reader of your blog, keep up the great work. We've spoken before about productivity and your advice proved very useful. I've started doing Pomodoro like you do and it's helped a lot. As a team lead, it's still quite tough to prevent interruptions, but certainly helps. I actually had a different question which I was wondering if you could help with. At the moment, I'm feeling a bit torn on what to learn next and do next. There are a bunch of technologies I could do with learning, blogs to write, talks to get going so I could present them. Key items are Docker, Kibana, a talk at a conference about a product we've just sourced through ThoughtWorks, blogging, leadership books, lean books, I'll talk on a new lean idea I've been working on. Frankly, I've got myself into a bit of a treading water from all the demand. I'm actually not doing much of anything. I did start to look at this a little like lean methodology with so many things in WIP or work in progress, lead time on each goes up. Anyway, I thought with your hectic lifestyle, you'd be able to relate to such problems and any advice." So this is a common problem, right, Darren? So you have some success in an area, and then what happens is that you suddenly get all these different ideas and all these different opportunities, right? And then so you usually get success because you're super productive, because you're focused on a thing, and then that thing leads to success and leads to all these opportunities. And then because all those opportunities come in, then you end up, just like you said, where you feel like you're doing nothing. And you may be doing nothing, because what you're doing is actually juggling opportunities and you're doing all the administrative overhead of these things as opposed to actually accomplishing work. And I've been there. This is one of the biggest things I struggle with now. So I'll try to give you the kind of best advice that I've found that's working for me. I just heard several times here of this analogy. I think Stephen Covey first said it in one of his books, is this idea of, you know, big rocks. You've got this cup, right? And you've got rocks, big rocks, and then you've got sand, and you've got, or you got pebbles, and you got sand, and you got water. And if you put in the water first, and then the sand, and then the pebbles, and then the big rocks, you know, it doesn't fit, right? It overflows, and you got a big mess. But if you put in the big rocks first, and then you put in the pebbles, and then you put in the sand, and then you pour in the water, it all kind of fits nicely in there. And so, you know, the idea behind this is that you got to figure out what are your big rocks, and you get those things done first, and you kind of push off to the side the other stuff, and those kinds of things will just fill in there. You know, things like email, right, and things like, you know, these kind of opportunities that are not quite so important. So you have to define what your big rocks are. If everything is priority one, nothing has priority, right? So pick one thing. Just pick one thing at a time and focus on that. So, you know, I'll give you an example here. So for my soft skills book here, I just did the audio version of this book, right? And so what I did was I recorded the entire audio version of this book in 1 week. So this is a 504-page book. It was 16 hours of audio. Those were my big rocks. Every day, I had like 8 to 10 chapters of recording, and that's the first thing that I worked on that day, was those things. And once those were done, then I worked on my other tasks. And so that's how I got that done, right? That could have taken me months. That could have taken me a year to record this entire audio book, right? Or I could have never gotten it done at all. But I did it in 1 week's time, simply by doing that, simply by making sure that I set one primary focus at a time. So that's really what you need to do, is just pick one thing, make that your big rock, make that the first thing that you work on during the day, and you get that thing done, and then you, when you finish that, then you pick your next priority task, and you make that your focus and do it. So don't try to have multiple focuses. You know, you obviously things are gonna happen and you're gonna have to deal with administrative things. You're gonna have to juggle more than one thing at a time, but you should always have one primary focus. And I'll recommend you a couple of books here. So one of them, you know, again, I'm trying to become more of an essentialist myself. I struggle with this, so but I found these books to be helpful and convicting for me and make me beat myself up. So here's two books. So Essentialism. So this is a really good book about, you know, making, you know, having that one focus, that one task. And then another book called The One Thing. So check out those books. I think that will help you to kind of get that mindset. And like I said, I'm still struggling with this myself. This is probably my biggest challenge now, as I've had all these opportunities and things happen, and you know, you got to pick which one that you're going to pursue. But you know, don't get stuck in that spot where you're not pursuing anything because you don't know what to do. It's better to just take some action than it is to take no action. So pick a thing, make it your big rock, and get that thing done. And as long as you always have a big rock, you'll always be making forward progress. You know, there's infinite ways of paths that you could take. But you know, if you're stuck at that crossroads and you're just standing there and you don't take any of them, then it's worse than having options, right? There's nothing worse than having options if you don't take them. But if you do take them, then there's a huge benefit there. So anyway, good question. I'll update you if I figure this out and get this down. But that's my advice for now. And like I said, I'm still working through the same problem. It's a difficult one. I've hired some help. That's helped me as well to pursue more opportunities. In fact, that's where I'm seeing, like, at the higher level is what, you know, I've got one employee, and I'll probably be, I'm hiring another part-term time person, and I've got different people that are helping me with different tasks now. So I'm not taking it all on myself. It allows me to do more things, but you can't be Superman. You can only do so much yourself. So you either got to pick one thing, do that one thing, or you got to expand. You got to hire people and delegate. So we'll see what happens. I'm curious to hear how this works out for you. And if you've got a question for me, don't forget to email me at john@simpleprogrammer.com, and I'll do a video for you. And as always, subscribe to the channel. Talk to you next time.